Is that a car? What's up, money geeks? Mr. V here. Welcome to another video, guys. So in today's video, we're going to take a look at ticker symbol SOLO, Electra Mechanica. This is a Canadian-based company that manufactures electric cars. And when I say electric cars, I might be overstating it because when you take a look at the pictures, it looks like a quarter of a car is not really a full car. So this company has actually tried to carve out a niche in the electric car space. So they're trying to address the problem of you needing way too much cars. So most people commute to work by themselves in their four-seater car. If you look around, most cars are four-seaters, right? So they're asking, like, why do you need all that extra space in your car when you commute to work all by yourself on a single day? So most people would be, oh, you should just get a motorcycle. But motorcycles are not super safe. You don't get the security and the protection that you would get from a car. So if it's raining when you're riding your motorcycle, you get wet. So they're trying to come up with something that it's a combination of a motorcycle. So it has the spacing of a motorcycle, but they get the safety and protection and a feel of a car. So that's how they came up with their SOLO, S-O-L-O car. So let's jump in and actually take a look at this company, see exactly what the product looks like, see what the problem they're solving in the market, look at their financials, and then see if this is a buy or it's a don't touch. So let's jump in. And guys, this is a car that is actually designed to solve a particular problem in market for cars. So again, the name of the vehicle here is SOLO. That's the vehicle that they're putting out. And as you can see, look at the design. It's really tiny, has two tires in the front and one in the back. Kind of like a motorcycle per se, but has, you know, the look and feel, or has all the protection of a car. So I think, I mean, from what they, you know, the company is saying, it looks like there is a market for this. I'm not sure about this having a market in North America, just because North America has a lot of bigger cars, really, especially in the United States, very big or huge freeways. So when somebody's driving a bigger car and you're driving this on the freeway, you look like a cockroach next to them. So we'll see. But I can totally see a market for these in Europe. So again, it's an electric car. So here you can actually run the numbers to see what you would get per, you know, per year for maintenance and stuff like that. So at the time that I was actually doing this video, this stock is currently trading at $4.71. So if you see back in 2017, it was it went up to about $14.90 for a high. And then since then, 2018, so you've just been getting some rejection, and then made a little move back in 2019. And then 2020, I think it's gone up to about $4.71, as we can see today. So that is the little history about it for this car. Another thing I want to show you guys here is just talk a little bit about you know, the intricacies of this company. As you can see, the picture here really shows you everything you need to know about the car. If you look, it just looks like it doesn't have any wheels in the back, but there's one underneath. Again, from the front, it looks like a car that only takes one person. And then from the back, it really is slim and looks like, I don't know, like a motorcycle. So again, this is a problem that they're solving. Why do you need a four passenger car when you drive to work all by yourself? So that's where that SOLO comes from. SOLO means like, hey, you just do it all by yourself. So people don't want to use these micro mobility ways, scooters and motorcycles and bicycles, because of no safety and protection features and stuff like that. You get exposed to the elements, and then limited range. And then for a car, it's just too big and expensive, you know, oversized use of space that you don't really need. And so that's where they came up with this design. So kind of combine, you know, the micro mobility here and the passenger vehicles to slim down version of a car. So the prototype 2015 to 2017, pre-market production 2019 to 2020, and then 2020 plus, that's when it's supposed to be in production. So they say capable of producing up to 20,000 solos annually. That's pretty huge. So we'll see how that pans out. Again, this is what the design really looks like, if you can go into the nuances of it. The price here, if you notice, you're talking about $18,500. Like a typical Harley Davidson motorcycle would cost you upwards of about $25,000 to $30,000. So this is even cheaper than a motorcycle. Again, it's electric, so that has that, adds that little feature to it. And so this is a comparison of what you would have today. So if you take the Solo, $18,500, if you look at the range of the Mini Cooper, Nissan Leaf, and Chevy Bolt, and Tesla, look at the price range, all the way to or close to about $40,000 for Tesla. So, I mean, the difference is you have, all these ones are four-seater cars, and this one is just a one-seater. So, I can see how it really fits the need of you not wasting that space and all that, just for you driving every day to work. But what happens if you have to go out on a date? Do you make your date take a taxi or what? I mean, that is some of the questions I would ask about this. Again, just kind of some of the stuff that they're trying to explain, that 76% of people travel to work by themselves, which is cool. But that one day that you have a coworker that needs a ride and you can't give them because you have your supposedly car/motorcycle. This is just some of the statistics that they put out there. Again, just showing more details as to what the problem this company is trying to solve. And this is their path through to profitability. This is the part that interests me. So I don't really care about the car. I care about how we can make money off of it. That's, to me, that's what's more important. So just kind of give you like a guideline as to when they're going to ramp up their production and start selling cars and making some money. And so this is what they're currently looking at from a licensing standpoint in the United States, and who can get the car. So so you can get a motorcycle license to drive it. It's not really considered. In some states, it looks like just your driver's license is good. In others, you need a motorcycle license to actually drive it. So, which is okay. See, California is actually giving a $750 state incentive to own something like that. I think Oregon is doing the same thing, but they don't have a particular amount there. So this is the kind of the rollout. So from what we see here, it looks like the rollout is going to start in the United States here, 2020, and then eventually get into Germany, same in 2020, and then move across Europe. And this is the part where I said I really see the European market will probably be ideal for this, because Europeans are really accustomed to having these smaller cars. But in the United States, I want to see how this can really survive in the US. Again, like I said, there's a lot of factors that make this car not really viable in the United States, just because of the sheer size of the car. I know cars like a Nissan Leaf and stuff like that haven't even picked up here in the United States. So it'll be interesting to see how this really goes. So, but by 2040, they anticipate to really take a lot of Europe. So we'll see how that goes. And then just looking at the financials, there's really nothing to show here. Basically, this is not a profitable company yet. I mean, if you look at the balance sheet here, nothing really, the revenue, nothing is really there to report. So basically just, they're bleeding money. So if you look at their total asset and look at their total liability, so total liability and the equity, it's not really a number that I would say this is exciting. From a money standpoint, I can actually see how right now, until they start selling cars, they're not going to be profitable. They're just going to keep bleeding money. And again, another way for them to make some extra money would probably be just diluting their shareholders and increasing the share size and making more money from that way to try to keep the company afloat. Otherwise, I think the concept makes sense. It's just a matter of having people, adopt this new concept and hopefully something that can excite people enough to want to jump on a car like this. So I guess the question here is that, Mr. V, what do you think about Electra Mechanica? Is it a buy or is it exciting? So personally, I'm just gonna sit on the sideline for this one. I'm not gonna jump in, just because when I look at the actual car itself, it's not something that I can see that is super attractive to people to want to jump in there. A lot of people, when you get a new car, you like to, show your friends. You like to, take your friends for a ride. If you want to go out on a date, you want to pick up your date in a car. And this really takes away that. So basically, it's just you buy this and put it in your driveway. You can commute from your house to work and back. And then if you have to go on a date, then you put that on the side and they take your four-seater car or your two-seater car so you can pick up your date and take them out. So there's a lot of issues for society to want to adapt to this. But again, there's a market for everything. There's some people that don't really care about, if they have a date, they'll probably tell them to take a taxi or take a cab to just meet them there. So there's that possibility. So I'm going to sit on the sideline and watch this one. If I don't see, if I see a lot of excitement, if it starts to make a move, then I'll get in. But as of right now, I'll watch it inside. So question of the day, what do you think about this car? Do you think, Mr. V, you are totally missing the point here? There is a huge market for this. Or you think, man, this car is funny looking? Let me know in the comment section. And as always, guys, like, share, subscribe. YouTube tells me that 90% of you haven't already subscribed to your channel. So hit that subscribe button and the notification bell. And also, if you're looking at starting to invest, Weibo is currently doing a promotion where they give you two free stocks, one value between $2 and $250, and the second one between $12 and $1,400. So I'm gonna put the links in the description below so you can definitely go check them out. And as always, stay motivated. We'll be right back.